Abdallah Absi, speaker number 3, is the CEO of Zoomaal, the leading crowdfunding platform in the Arab world. So far, it's helped over 100 creative projects and entrepreneurship projects from the Arab world. His work, Zoomaal, has been featured on CNN, Forbes, Wamda, Arabian Business, and Al-Jazeera. He's founded 6 startups, and he's only 23. How does that work? I don't know. You're 2, you just start a business of what, lollipops? Seriously. And Absi has also been listed under the 100 most powerful Arabs under 40 on the Arabian Business. A great inspiration to me personally and a good friend. A big round of applause to Abdallah Absi. Long line. Woo!
Who's changing? I'll just... Seriously? No. I requested for that not to happen. Okay. So first, no recording because I have a lot of some members here in Zoomaal who are not used to me saying the F word. And more ex-Zoomalians actually here. Okay, so I'm going to start with some early fuck-ups that I've done at a very early stage, but I don't call them fuck-ups because I think it was more because I was like 16, 17. So I'll just jump to Reflex. Reflex was a startup just before Zoomaal. It's kind of very similar to what Sami has said. We were working in Lebanon, and then suddenly, out of nowhere, a $2 million startup was funded. A startup was funded in the US for $2 million. And then after 6 months, it was acquired for like $30 million, and they had like 10% of the technology we had. So that was like really shocking for us. But anyway, moving on. Zoomaal, next. So that's kind of a real life fuck up now. It's kind of hard and embarrassing because I'm speaking about something that's still existing and it's working. So anyway, Zoomaal started in July 2012. And from the first day, we got VC funding. We got four VCs putting in money with Zoomaal, from MEVP to Wamda to Wire Ventures. So all the previous fuck-ups who I never got funding from anyone for them. Now Zoomaal, suddenly we have a lot of funding. So I was happy with that. And then for the next 6 months, I was working on, I was really bootstrapping the model. After 6 months, we got the first member in Zoomaal. We were bootstrapping at night, and if you're familiar with this, with noodles, midnight noodles, then you've been really bootstrapping. Curry was our favorite. So we spent a lot. We had a lot of challenges from July 2012 to 2013. It took us almost a year to actually launch a product because we had a lot of legal challenges, payments. We had to acquire users and projects, like entrepreneurs in the region. That it wasn't very easy for us. It's a very challenging market. We had to educate people what crowdfunding is. It's not begging for money and all of that. So yeah, flash forward from that date. July 2013 was the launch of Zoomaal. It was the most special day for us. We've been bootstrapping as 2 members, and suddenly we have everything working. We have the payments, we have the website live, and we have amazing, like we had Mashrua Layla just jumping on board with us, raising funds through the platform. So at that event, we had a lot of people invited. We got the US Embassy, Netherlands Embassy. We had a lot of international supporters and organizations coming in, some people from the ecosystem. We had a lot of people, like friends and people who are excited about this kind of launch. And now came the talk that I have. I was kind of maybe good looking, but it wasn't that good. Okay. So I like normal speeches, yeah. That's the first time I put this kind of tie. So just like in a normal lunch speech, I have to go on and say, yeah, today is a very special day for everyone, and we're very excited to have you here. And then the thank yous start. So I start with thanking our VCs, MEVP, and so on. And then I say thank you to the US Embassy and to the friends and family who supported Zoomaal. And enjoy your night and so on. And then the band starts playing. So I go down from the stage, and then suddenly the Netherlands Embassy came out of nowhere and, hey, you forgot to mention us. So I didn't want to, like, I would get myself embarrassed, but I don't want to break or burn my card with them. So I went back on the stage and I said, oh, and yes, thank you very much for the Netherlands Embassy also for being here. And then I went down, and then suddenly someone else pops. And so we were doing it at the Coworking 961. It was just launching. Not yet. Oh, go back. So it was Coworking 961, yeah. I'll do it. Coworking 961 was just launching, and Hala Fadel was like, who's a chairman of the MIT Enterprise Forum and the founder of all of this. So I also forgot to mention her. So I went back on the stage, and thank you very much, Hala Fadel, and thank you for supporting us and making this event possible through the Coworking 961, providing us everything for free and all of that. And that was it. So I went down, and I was hoping this is going to be a fun night and everyone is going to enjoy it, although I was kind of like red and embarrassed. Anyway, so we enjoyed the night, and I then figured that from one of my friends that I forgot to mention the team. He told me, what about your team? It wasn't like a team, it was only one member with me. So it wasn't that hard to mention. Yeah, it was hard. So the event like was closed anyways, and nobody, like everyone left. So when I got back to work the next day, I had to have a talk with that member, explaining myself and telling him, okay, I really appreciate what you've been doing, and there are no, like, I didn't really mean that. I just forgot. When I went on stage, by the way, it was all improvised, which was terrible. I'm in a lunch event and I'm improvising. So I had to, like, talk to him, but, I mean, after a month, he resigned. So, yeah, you know, it's a real fuck up, and you just can't, like, rewind it back and just fix the situation. So I was all alone, yeah. I don't think he's here, but he's a regular member of the community, Ziad Alim. All thanks and love to him. So yeah, next slide. So if you watched the latest Steve Jobs movie, Steve Wozniak always keeps telling Steve Jobs that you have to give credit to the team who released the product. And all the time, he just never says anything. It's like no comment. So I just put مخصك. It's another way of saying I don't deal with this. And you shouldn't do this. That's a really big, bad thing that anyone could ever do in a startup. As a CEO or a startup founder, you would not feel that maybe the team needs recognition or the motivation that they need, because you're just too fucked up with other things that you forget about that. But they need that, and they always need the kind of push to feel that they belong, that they're doing something that's great, that they're part of the vision, all of that. So that's kind of the lesson learned. Next. First, don't do the thank yous. Like, if you want to ever do a thank you, okay, just get a paper and put all the people that on your Facebook friends list. Put them, all of them, okay? Or just don't mention anyone. That's the only solution, because if you go there improvising, saying thank yous, you're going to miss someone, and someone is going to be really pissed off, and you're going to be pissed off after the event. And the second thing is always keep recognizing your team and motivate them. They're the greatest asset and the biggest asset for anyone. Thank you, Sarah. She's a Zoomalian. Batfishi. Next. Okay. So I confidently would not like to thank Aisha first for Aisha and Old City for organizing this fucked up night. And no thank you to all of you fuckers. No recording.
We take questions from the Zoomalians first, and then Sami, and then the team.
Come on, six startups. Mm-hmm. I need at least.
She was an ex-Zoomalian, by the way.
Yeah, just I worked with him for a year. And three lessons learned, summarizing all the stuff, like just list them, bullet points, please, and send them.
Everything? No, that's too much. I mean, just before. I wouldn't mention a lot of things about Zuma because I fuck up every single day. And I still do maybe the same fuck ups that I'm doing. But in the previous startups, notably most of the most one is Reflex. I worked on it 3 years, almost the same period that I'm now working on Zoomaal. The biggest fuck up for me for all these previous startups was really funding. I wasn't able to get funding from VCs. Partially it was for my age. I think they didn't find me serious that I'm 17 asking for $100,000 or $500,000. But at the same time, I mean, like any entrepreneur in the beginning and thinking really big and want to be the kind of Silicon Valley billion-dollar company, they start putting projections that are almost impossible to have. So even if you're giving out the business plans, you have to give them to these local VCs. They want you to come and show that this is going to be a billion-dollar business, but at the same time, they want to show like proof that that's going to happen. That's impossible. So that's, I mean, I did fuck up a lot, and with the numbers and everything. And if you ask any VC, by the way, and any analyst in those kind of VCs, they will tell you that numbers are, you just create them. You can create any business right now, any startup, and you can just create the very nice numbers that you want to see in them, and grow them, and put the right assumptions that those numbers are going to grow. So that's... short story.
Any regrets? Any regrets?
No, every fuck up is a lessons learned.
Okay, so I'm after you.
So this is not a question actually, but to share something that happened yesterday, similar to your actual fuck up that you're talking about here.
Okay.
So I don't know who of you was at AUB yesterday, who are actually hosting us with like the Center of Research and Innovation. And I kind of did some generic thank yous, not to miss people. And I did miss the actual venue who hosted us and didn't say anything about that. So that actually happened yesterday and I kind of...
It's now, too late, man.
Yeah, exactly.
We should have watched that before.
But I guess we have similar fuck-ups in what we do. So just want to share this with people here.
I think most fuck-ups that happen with startups, they just repeat themselves with other people.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I think that's the main learning from these kind of events.
Cool.
Any other questions? Another Zoomalian.
Hello, yes. I do work at Zoomaal.
Disclaimer.
Really, it gets really crazy, and... we always get a thank you through pancakes and gummy bears. I just wanted to really point this out. And we are well fed, you know, all the time. Shakes.
Okay, enough.
Okay, I'm just pointing this, okay, because now he thanks a lot. I can tell. Okay, that's it.
Thank you for your question. Oh, question over here.
I don't know, I may be repeating the question, but could you tell us about your early fuck-ups? Because I'm young and I want to create stuff and I see the problems like about the people, the VCs, and it's how they say to you, yeah, we want you to present, and they judge you because you're young and all that shit. And could you tell us more about your early fuck-ups in general? I'm sorry.
Man, it's really hard to like brief them up right now. But we can meet afterwards, and
sure.
Yeah, I would love to like even advise or mentor or yeah, I'd love to
that
do that.
That'd be great.
I'm a big supporter of young entrepreneurs. You know?
I support myself too.